BDS is a bull purity test by people who want to appear woke but actually slept through history class.
That's true.
It's very shallow thinking that the Jews are in Israel mostly white and the Palestinians are browner, so they must be innocent and correct, and the Jews must be wrong.
That's Bill Maher over the weekend firing back at the controversy surrounding Democratic Congresswoman Rashida Tlaib and Ilhan Omar. Since then, Tlaib has called for a boycott of his show, and now he's responding yet again. That brings us to our A-team this morning. Jessica Tarlov is a Fox News contributor. David Asman is the anchor for Bulls and Bears on the Fox Business Network. Guy Benson is a political editor for townhall.com, host of The Guy Benson Show on Fox News Radio. I find it so ironic, Guy, that Rashida Tlaib is denouncing Israel for trying to silence her voice, but now she wants to boycott Bill Maher because he disagrees with her.
Well, it sounds like she's into silencing, except for herself, right? She likes boycotting. She boycotts Israel. Now she's boycotting Bill Maher. This internecine fight on the left is interesting. I don't always agree with Bill Maher, but when I do, it's sort of fun. And on this one, I think he's exactly right. He also, later in that clip that we played, he talked about the anti-Semitic foundings of BDS. And that's not just Bill Maher quoting someone, one of the founders of BDS. Chuck Schumer has called BDS anti-Semitic. Nancy Pelosi called it dangerous, bigoted. And yet you have these two members of Congress, they are flag-waving supporters of BDS. It's an extraordinary thing to see, and I think Israel is definitely having the stronger side of this debate.
David?
What's really extraordinary to me is to see charges of anti-Semitism against a president whose daughter just became Jewish, was converted to Judaism, whose son-in-law is obviously Jewish, who is the best friend, according to many Israelis, that Israel has ever had. I just want to step back for a second. Just look at the personal, where America is right now. I don't think America is where either Tlaib or Bill Maher, it is not as racial and as consumed by the questions of anti-Semitism as everybody else is. We have to talk about it because it's interesting. My son-in-law is Jewish. My daughter-in-law is African-American. My wife is Nicaraguan. I'm probably more of a rainbow coalition than most Americans, but most Americans out there are beyond this discussion, this obsession with race. You saw the New York Times editorial board talking to each other about how everything is racism. Racism has to be discovered, whether we're covering science, whether we're covering culture. I think America is so far beyond this debate, and politicians just get wrapped up into it too much.
Well, let me perhaps bring it back a little bit in this tweet from Bill Maher, Jessica. He tweets, "Some people have only one move, boycott, cancel, make go away." But here's the thing. The House voted 318-17 to condemn the BDS movement, including 93% of Democrats. Does Tlaib want to boycott 93% of her own party? As the Democrat representative on this panel, how do you answer that?
I think on this issue, yes, she does want to boycott them. I mean, this is something she feels incredibly strongly about, Representative Ilhan Omar. There have been inconsistencies in their public stance on BDS. When they were campaigning, they were less forthright about their views on this and then kind of turned around. But Bill Maher is absolutely correct, and I do agree with him more often than Guy does. But when it does, it is an exciting moment for me as well. As a Democrat and as a Jewish American, he's absolutely correct about what BDS is and the danger that it poses. And I was happy that he highlighted how many Jews there are in the Democratic Party and their views on this. But to your point, David, about over-amplifying racial tensions in this country, mm-hmm. the American people are not past it. And we have a president who plays in a very dirty racial paddling pool by telling women of color to go back from where they came from. And we can talk about Bill Maher, but let's not ignore what the president did, talking about dual loyalty, which is a classic anti-Semitic trope, something he should never have spoken about, calling himself, you know, the king of Israel.
Let us not ignore either the fact that we just had the head of DNC communications, Ms. Hinojosa, bring an element of racism into a discussion of immigration that did not belong there. When she said, is it the color of the skin? Is that the reason why these people are being locked up in cages? I mean, that was
but
so
when you look
totally...
At-
was it a question of the color of skin that led Jay Johnson to view immigrants in cages during the Obama administration? You don't have bring this issue of racism where it doesn't belong. You don't.
If there are policies that are specifically targeting people, certain groups, we don't have a policy.
It's not targeting people of color. That's not the purpose of it.
What color are the people in those cages?
In crisis.
Okay, but legal immigration visa overstays are the problem, not the people crossing the southern border. No, it's not. Statistically, it is not.
Guy, come back in here.
Well, on what? I'll pick immigration for a second because I thought the interview with the DNC spokeswoman was quite interesting on a number of levels. First of all, she sort of shook her finger at the Republicans on hypocrisy. They said, you worry about the children on abortion, but not on this. Well, whatever you think of this border policy and detention, Republicans are not calling for the killing of children at the border, which is what the Democrats support in terms of abortion. Unfettered, taxpayer-funded abortion.
That's absolutely untrue.
What is not untrue?
That it's about the killing of children. We just saw Kevin McCarthy promoting that lie that we're for abortion after a child has been born.
I said abortion through all 9 months of pregnancy, which is what the Democratic Party supports, paid for by taxpayers. It's radical. It's extreme. Those are people being killed. And then
You think a doctor would go in, a licensed medical professional, and say...
It is the ending of a human life, and that is not what's happening at the border at the hands of the government. I just think it's...
Well, there are a lot of kids, actually, that are dying in border facilities. Can they get their flu shots?
Not because we are killing them actively in our government. I just think it's to call Republicans hypocrites for not caring about children in this context, and then bringing abortion into it, I think, is like a really bad argument for the Democrats to be making.
I thought Xochitl Hinojosa made a point that she probably didn't intend to make. She's saying we should be vaccinating these children for the flu. Well, isn't that one of the issues with unfettered immigration across the border? You have children and adults coming into this country. We have no record of their immunizations. We have no idea what's going to happen when they get out into, the broader pool of the public. They have not been vaccinated by and large in those countries, and we don't know that.
Yeah, I think that every person in one of our facilities should have the right to see a doctor, to get their immunizations. They should have soap, toothpaste, toothbrush. But the talk about what they're bringing in here, the infestation talk, the invasion talk is dangerous. That's what the El Paso shooter was talking about.
I think Democrats are in a real political bind when it comes to immigration. Remember, they were the ones who were saying there was no crisis at the border when clearly there was a crisis at the border. They were the ones who were saying that you can't separate families. Now that the families are being kept together, they're opposed to that. They have a real crisis of identity. Exactly where they stand. Are they for catch and release or are they against catch and release?
Guy?
Yeah, that I think is the fundamental problem with all of this outrage about the indefinite detention of children together with their families. If the existing law were to stay in place, and I'm not sure the president has the power to do what he's trying to do, but if the existing status quo continued and you have kids then leaving after 20 days, they scream about family separations. That's the cruelest thing you can imagine. Now, this is the cruelest thing, keeping them together indefinitely, talking about like it's Guantanamo Bay. These families can also leave. They can go back home if they want to. They're not being imprisoned there forever against their will. I just think there's a lot of The situation is broken and complicated. There's a lot of reckless rhetoric coming, I think, from both sides.
It's a huge issue and one that's not going to be solved easily. Big A-team this morning. Mm-hmm.
We'll talk about Dancing with the Stars
another time.
I'm sure it'll be a story still next week when we all reconvene.
Guy Benson, David Asman, Jessica Tarlov, thank you.
Thank you.